Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. In this video we are going to see about the basics of electromagnetic relay. First of all, the relays. The relays are the protective equipment for our yard or switch gear or switch yard substation equipments. So the relays, the protective equipment which is kept in the secondary side of our buildings, which means the primary equipments are protected by these secondary relays. So this is the basic trip circuit operation of our relay. First of all, the bus bar, the main bus bar, and then one breaker, then one CT, then it is connected to another bus bar. Likewise, I have taken here just for an example. In this, there is a one fault occurring as a overcurrent or earth fault, whatever the fault may be. So whenever the fault occurs, the main thing is that the primary CT primary, which is and connected in a series with this line, then the secondary of the CT is connected to the relay coil. In here I have mentioned as relay coil, which means the primary CT and then the primary CT, which senses the current and it goes to the which means it induces through the secondary of the CT. That secondary of the CT is connected to the relay coil. Then breaker, I have shortly mentioned as CB. Here the circuit breaker, which is connected with the tripping coil, which means the breaker tripping coil, then the tripping coil circuit, then the relay coils and the relay contacts. Now as I said, the system, this line is to be protected. Now for example, the fault is occurred as a overcurrent or earth fault or over voltage, whatever the fault may be. When the fault occurs, the CT will sense a high current more than the set value. So As you know that whenever the set value exceeds the fault value exceeds the set value, automatically the relay coil get energized, and the relay coil which pushes the relay contacts to make each other. After making each other, automatically the circle this circuit get fulfilled. For example, here the source which we have used is AC or DC, whatever the source may be. As I said, the relay coil get energized and the relay contacts make each other, which means it touches the circuit and fulfills the circuits. So after fulfilling, automatically the trip get initiated, which means the DC. For example, the DC source we are giving, one end will be a positive and another end will be a negative. When this trigger relay contact get touched to each other, means one pulse will be generated to the trip coil of the breaker and the trip will be initiated. Then the breaker will opens. Automatically, this faulty line get isolated from the healthy line. So this is the basics of a operation of a tripping circuit for which the relay coils, contacts and relays are being connected. So now we will go to the electromagnetic relays. Here the electromagnetic relay, there are two types of which means various types of electromagnetic relays, like electromagnetic attraction type, electromagnetic induction type. So right now we are going to see about the electromagnetic attraction type. In this, there is a coil. There is a coil which get energized by the electromagnetic waves, which means the electromagnet which is surrounded by a coil, and when operating current is larger than the larger means get initiated more due to the fault current, means automatically the magnetic field will be produced in the electromagnet, So as the electromagnetic magnetic field is produced, the armature get attracted. The armature, in the sense, it is a moving iron piece or iron material, whatever it may be. The force of attraction which attracts the armature and triggers the tripping circuit. So this is the basics of the electromagnetic attraction relay. This is further classified into two types, which is attracted armature relay and solenoid and plunger type relay. This attracted armature relay is classified into two: hinged armature type and polarized moving ion type. So as I said, this is your magnet. The magnet is surrounded by a coil. Here the coil input is AC or DC current or voltage, whatever it may be. Then a spring will be connected to the top of the coils magnet, which means this spring which produces some of the restraining force. Whenever the fault current is happening, this coil get energized, then it will makes this electromagnet to make some force, which is the electromagnetic force. And this electromagnetic force is higher than the level, means in that time the armature iron particles get attracted and it will be moves. So the moving force here, the moving force which should be greater than the restraining force of your spring, which means the spring will be normally in a resetted condition, which means it will be like a free condition. So due to some of the restraining force, the free springs get which means the spring should be get released. For that releasing, we are going to have some of the initiated, which means the fault current initiated magnetic force, and that force will attract the armature and automatically it will connect to a circuit and the tripping circuit will get initiated. Same principle for the polarized moving ion particle. Here the moving ion get attracted to the two of them, and it will get the initiation to the tripping circuit. Here the attraction is carried by this input current or voltage, which means the coil get energized, and this part is your magnet. This magnet will see, this is the north and south pole. This magnet get some of the forces which will attract the moving contact and it will connect to the tripping circuit. So this is the basics of the electromagnetic attraction relays of both. Next, solenoid or plunger type. In here, as per the concept, all are the same processing and procedures and principle also same. Here also we have one electromagnet and it is connected to a coil, which means surrounded by a coil, the coil which can initiate a AC or DC current or a voltage. Then a moving ion plunger, which means a moving particle, then surrounded by a tripping circuit, which means tripping coil. Here there is some of the spring which consists of some of the restraining force. Normally the spring will be in a resetted condition. Whenever the high fault is occurred, the coil get energized, and the energization will happen some of the electromagnet to get some force, and that electromagnetic force should overcome the restraining force which is connected to the movable iron plunger. Then after overcoming the restraining force, the moving plunger get attracted to the magnet and automatically the trip coil get initiated. While attracting, the trip coil is placed between the movable iron, which means the movable plunger and the magnet. So automatically this is an iron particle. It will conduct the current. So whenever it is moving towards the electromagnet, automatically it will touches the tripping circuit, and the tripping circuit, as you know, for the tripping circuit which is connected to your breaker trip coils, it will have some forces, like which means source, like AC or DC voltage source, that one end will be, for example, one end will be in DC as a negative and another end will be a positive. Automatically this plugger get attracted and touches each other. In that time, a pulse, a positive pulse will be initiated to the trip coil. So moving over to the advantages and disadvantages of a electromagnetic relay. So the main advantage is that it can be used for both AC and DC power. Then second thing is that it is a fast operating and also easily resetted. Then it is a almost instantaneous, which means a immediate tripping type of electromagnetic relay. So nowadays what we have done, which means what the research and development have been done, is that the operating time varies with your current value, which means for example, I am saying that for a over current or a over voltage or a under voltage relays, we can keep a set value, which means a tripping time as a 110% of the current value or 110% of the voltage value. For under voltage, 80% of the voltage value, or undercurrent is, there is no like that. For under voltage, there is a 80% of this total voltage. Then for earth fault relays also, we can keep as a instantaneous and also some timing level, which means we can vary that operating time with varies with the current level. So we can easily able to produce a various tripping and all tripping settings and alarm settings and all. So the main disadvantage is that the operational feature is absent, which means the directional feature is absent. Then second thing is that it will be easily affected by the transient or false tripping, which means normally the set value will be in an accurate level or more or less equal to the fault level. Suppose if we have kept the set values as a under the or below the fault level, means automatically the tripping will be initiated even for the transient, which means that. So these are all the main advantages, disadvantages and applications of the electromagnetic relay. Hope you understand it. And these are all the main basics of the electromagnetic relay. Thanks everyone. Keep sharing my videos, then support my channel. Thanks everyone. Share your knowledge and gain your knowledge. Nandri, Vanakkam.